There is some sort of intersection between these UAP or UFO sightings and our nuclear technology with nuclear propulsion, nuclear power generation, or nuclear weapons systems. Those same observations have been seen overseas in other countries.
You have objects being tracked on radar performing at speeds that no object on Earth can perform. You have eyewitness military personnel. You have jet pilots.
Section 51.
Hi everyone, what's up guys? Dos Geek here with Section 51. Big thanks again for your support to the channel. As always, first, please hit that like button and share this new video right now to keep supporting Section 51. And don't forget, of course, that it is very important to watch this video until the end. If you are ready, let's start right now. Officially, the US government ended its study of UFOs in 1969 because it assured the public there is no proof the phenomenon represents a threat to national security. But what if these unknown aircrafts showed an interest in our nuclear weapons? A group of more than 150 military veterans, missile officers, security personnel, including many who worked at the Nevada test site, say they have seen mystery intruders over nuclear facilities. We don't know who is piloting these crafts or why they are poking around, but dozens of witnesses and thousands of pages of documents suggest someone is monitoring our nukes. The Department of Energy admits there is a long history of UFO activity over nuclear weapons facilities elsewhere, but zero cases at the former Nevada test site. Very strange, don't you think? Would we try once again to hide everything that is happening in this area of Nevada, which is well known for its many mysteries? And especially for the Area 51 and its black projects, which are allegedly developed here in full desert. The documentary film UFOs and Nukes, made by Robert Hastings in 2016, explores some of the most dramatic episodes that include testimonies of people who witnessed strange UFO sightings over these nuclear weapons facilities. In the darkest days of the Cold War, atomic weapons were routinely exploded above ground at the Nevada test site, the most nuked place on Earth. I cannot even imagine the level of radiation that is still going on there today. In 1955, 14 A-bombs were detonated as part of Operation Teapot, witnessed by thousands of military personnel in trenches and thousands more test site employees. But there were other observers as well.
It was what we call the flying saucers. They were pretty prevalent at the test site during those years.
At least a dozen former test site employees have told similar stories about unknown aircraft showing up hours or days after an atomic blast. Author and investigator Robert Hastings has spent more than 40 years locating and interviewing military veterans, missile officers, and others who worked in various parts of the atomic weapons program. More than 150 of them so far. They have all told the same story.
In fact, UFOs have routinely monitored our nuclear weapons going back decades, and on occasion apparently it actually interfered with the functionality of those weapons.
In addition to the eyewitness accounts, thousands of pages of formerly classified documents have been released to buttress these tales. FOIA requests, or Freedom of Information Act, filed in 1992, produced a thick stack of documents from the Department of Energy indicating UFO incidents over every major atomic weapons facility dating to the late 40s over Los Alamos National Lab where the bombs were designed, over Hanford where the plutonium was processed, but they pretend they have no records of any official sightings over what later became the Nevada test site. Hastings, however, has found plenty.
Civilians living near the proving ground often observe the aerial discs. sometimes flying in large formations, and subsequently notified the Air Force.
So the documentary film, which is the culmination of Hastings' years of research, includes chilling incidents where UFOs have not only infiltrated restricted airspace over nuclear missile bases, but on occasion had disabled ICBMs, or intercontinental ballistic missiles, and put the military on high alert. In one dramatic incident from the film, military photographers using telescopic lenses watched a UFO disable a warhead used in a missile test fired from Vandenberg AFB.
Flying out over the Pacific, suddenly this domed disc, an object with a dome, came into frame, circled the warhead, which was flying about 8 or 10,000 miles an hour, shot 4 beams of light at it, whereupon the dummy warhead fell into the Pacific Ocean, and the UFO left the facility.
UFO incidents at the Nevada test site became so routine, according to a former security officer named Walter Levin, that the teams were assigned to the job of specifically looking for them at a specially equipped building in Indian Springs Air Base, now known as Creech. Levin told Hastings,
"They were all luminous. They were disc-shaped. Some of them were square-shaped. We were to pick up a telephone in this little shack. There was no dial tone. The voice would just come on. We would read off all these coordinates, the direction of the object, the altitude, etc. And then, when we wrote this stuff down on a piece of paper, we were then to burn the paper in a trash can in the shack."
The government ended atomic weapons tests years ago, but Nevada incidents apparently continue. Former security officers at Area 2 at Nellis Air Force Base for years, a storage facility for up to 200 nuclear warheads, have reported multiple intrusions by unknown aircraft from the late 90s through 2004. Hastings also said,
"You have objects being tracked on radar performing at speeds that no object on Earth can perform. You have eyewitness military personnel. You have jet pilots.
Witnesses to these incidents are often highly trained personnel with top security clearances. In recent years, their reports are being corroborated by sophisticated technology. So apparently, UFO reports do occur more frequently in the vicinity of nuclear sites, after controlling for population and the region of the country. Nuclear facilities seem to significantly attract UFOs. Given that the motives of the intelligences behind UFOs, assuming that UFOs are intelligently controlled, are not well known, all the people in every country, we should be concerned. Given the long history of UFO incursions at sensitive, highly restricted nuclear facilities, and given that the events of September the 11th of 2001 have drawn attention to the vulnerability of nuclear power plants to terrorist acts, it would seem to convince national security agencies to redirect some attention to the issue of UFOs entering restricted airspace over nuclear facilities." Speaking recently to the Washington Post, Luis Elizondo, former director of the military's Advanced Aerospace Threat Identification Program, revealed that UFOs, or whoever pilots them, are fascinated with nuclear energy.
"There is some sort of intersection between these UAP, or UFO sightings, and our nuclear technology with nuclear propulsion, nuclear power generation, or nuclear weapons systems. Those same observations have been seen overseas in other countries."
Similar incidents have been reported in the UK, India, Pakistan, and other nuclear powers in the 90s. I guess that even Russia, as a great world power, also recorded some strange UFO incursions in its own sensitive areas and startling incidents over its nuclear power plants. But it's still difficult to have access to classified documents from their Ministry of Defense. Finally, the impressive number of all these incidents and their level of dangerousness forces even the most skeptical to accept that there are many UFO phenomena around nuclear power plants and nuclear missile launch zones. and any country is potentially threatened. But it still doesn't answer some questions. Who is behind these incidents and why? Who knows what their motivation is? As for the conquest of space, then of the moon, all we can hope for now is that there will be some kind of competition between countries as to which country will first reveal its most secret documents concerning possible contacts with an extraterrestrial intelligence. Will it be the United States or Russia? I'm sure we still have a lot of very interesting things to discover, and maybe signing a petition might help further to put pressure on the US government, for example, to ask them to release all unclassified data, photos, videos to the public as soon as possible, and to achieve the congressionally mandated UFO report we all deserve at. It's the pressure of the people that can maybe help to know the whole truth on the subject. So check out the link to this petition in the description below this video to participate and grow our ranks. I hope you enjoyed this video. Section 51 is on social networks, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Don't forget to hit that like button and that bell button too. Don't forget to share the video, to sign the petition and to subscribe to Section 51. Thank you again. This was DosGeek with Section 51. I'll be back really soon. Open your eyes, watch the sky, live long and prosper.